moving to okay.
No, you can keep talking.
You know,
it used to be fun when we used to do that. Like,
what we used to do. You do it then.
When we used to have pre-show dialogue.
Pre-show dialogue is cool, but it just depends on what you guys are talking about, because y'all talk about inappropriate things, and I'm just not going to be part of that.
It's nothing inappropriate. It's just, you know, what it is. Bundles away. All right, we're getting set here, guys. If you're tuned in right now, thank you for watching. We're just getting things set up. Give us a couple of more seconds here, and we will start the show.
Hello, everyone.
Hello, Ty.
Hey.
Now make sure you look at the upper left.
Why?
That upper right corner, he mean.
Oh, upper right, the live?
Yeah. Uh-huh.
So don't you say nothing.
Why is Eric, like, Ty, don't you remember? All right, we're not done show yet. Ty, don't you remember when we used to have pre-show dialogue and it was actually fun?
Yeah, what's wrong with that?
Yeah, I don't understand why they're so scared now. Like, they act like you're scared of a hot mic. Like,
I am.
Because they all have jobs.
You don't want to lose no more friends next?
They're trying to be somebody in life.
Them hot mics get you blocked on social media.
I never got blocked. I say that to a lot of people. Ew, like I'm like super close. Do you know how close I am?
No, we don't. All right, ready? So it's show 3, 2, 1. Thanks for being professional, guys. 2016 was a year of years. Things that we thought would never happen actually happened. And that is why we are here to culminate such times with an award show honoring the best and the worst of the year. Welcome to the 2016 Bro Talk Live Awards. My name is Jay Urban. Let's kick it to my main man, Dex. What up, bro?
Dex the one here. Really quickly before we start the awards show off, I cannot like have gotten through this season without the power of the Unicorns. That's a new Team Dex thing. I also want to give a big shout out to the former WWE Tag Team Champions, The New Day. They just lost their titles, but actually this whole year they've been preaching the power of positivity, and it's something that I stood by, and I've had an amazing year. So thank you to all of those who believe, and thank you guys for all tuning in.
And what is that? Like, what do you, where did that come from? Like, what's going on? Like,
who's
what is that?
Noise.
What's that little sign you just did? Do that sign again.
This is the sign for the unicorn. it's team, if you're part of the team, and it's called the team of self. And if you believe, like, you could throw the signs up. If you don't believe, like, you're not allowed to do it, and your life would just be miserable. You can say that it's not, but it really is.
Then that
it sounds like you all a bunch of self-serving people who want to be rich white women.
I don't gather that.
Wasn't that the tag team that just was like they were like they broke the record?
483 days. These guys were the tag team champions.
Are you serious?
Longest reigning tag team champions in the WWE's history.
Good to know. A couple of black guys. Great.
And African Americans. I'm just gonna put that out there too.
Tata God, what you snacking on? Is that part of the festivities that we honored you guys with tonight? Like the Golden Globes, you know, where they serve dinner and give you snacks and stuff like that. Is that part of what you're eating right now?
Yeah. I was sent this package right here. And it's full of like little goodies.
Snacks.
And, yeah. So I'm eating the popcorn.
Professional. Bill, how are you, sir?
I'm wonderful. I don't have any snacks. I don't have any stories to tell. I don't have any unicorns, no glitter to throw, you know.
How boring.
Somebody has to be. You are over here scarfing down popcorn. He's living in a land of unicorns, glitter, and daffodils on his way to see the wizard. Like, somebody has to be.
Well rounded.
Bloodstained banner for holiness.
So called.
All right. Well, let's start the award show off with some things that you know the people voted on and that we can get right to. And the first award that we're going to do tonight. Is going to be the Viral Moment of the Year Award. And these viral moments are moments that, you know, just really hit people this year in a way that, you know, hasn't been done in about 365 days previous. So these are the nominees for viral moment of the year. The first one up is Beans, Greens, Potatoes, Tomatoes, and that was by Pastor Shirley Caesar. Next up, we had Ray Shremmerd with the Mannequin Challenge. They had the anthem to that with the Black Beatles song. Thirdly, we have Pokemon Go, which was a huge thing that happened over the summer, which had everyone downloading this stupid game on their phones and going door to door and trying to catch invisible monsters. Harambe was also a huge hit in 2016, as his passing was commemorated multiple times, including among some populations, including in the presidential elections. And last but not least, Joanne the Scammer had a huge year on social media, including he got invited to the MTV VMAs this year. Very big for a person off of social media, really, with no other experience to hit that award show's red carpet. So, guys, those are the nominees for the first award of the night, the viral moment of the year. So who do you think should take it for the award this year? Is it, you name it, Harambe, Pokemon Go, the Mannequin Challenge, or Joanne the Scammer? What do you guys think?
I would guess.
What did you say, Tom?
I think the Mannequin Challenge was pretty big, but it's probably you name it.
The you name it challenge. Okay, so you're gonna go with you name.
Excuse me.
So which one are you voting for, Ty? Did you just choke on a nut or something like that? What's going on?
I'm dying. I don't remember which one I voted for.
Get your heads out together, guys. Come on, bro.
I think I may have voted for Mannequin.
All right, Bill, what did your vote go for? Mannequin Challenge, Joanne the Scammer. Which one are you going with, Harambe?
Come on, outfit number two. I'm going to go with... I'm actually going to go with the Mannequin Challenge. Everybody and their mother and their school did it, so that's what I'm going with.
All right, you're going with the Mannequin Challenge. Dex, new outfit. I like that. Blending in with the green screen there.
More unicorns, just so you guys know. This is a hard one for me, though. I didn't think it was the Mannequin Challenge, because I think that's fairly new. But I thought it was really between Harambe and... Harambe was the one, and then there was another one that I thought was and Joanne the Scammer. I thought those were two really big ones because, Jason, like you said, like Joanne was invited to the MTV Movie Awards. Tiana Taylor actually did a whole parody where she dressed up as him or her. I'm not sure. Dressed up as the person for like Halloween and did a whole skit. Like, Joanne the Scammer was really big, and to come from like a small Instagram and blow up like that is truly amazing, I think. Also, I think Harambe was a really big one because it inspired a lot of other animals to start attacking human beings. Like, that was one of the biggest moments for animals because, like, Harambe did it, and then the alligator snatched the little boy up in Florida, and then there were monkeys fighting people. Like, animals really started to feel themselves this year after the whole Harambe thing. Like, they kind of got revenge on us. It was Jumanji.
They got revenge on us.
Yes. It was like Jumanji in real life.
And so by us, you mean... Never mind.
Us human beings. Jason, what do you think?
My vote personally, out of these five contestants, would have went to the Mannequin Challenge. I just feel like that was the biggest thing this year. It kind of went super viral. It got Ray Shremmerd their first Hot 100 number one single. It was the biggest song in the country for a little bit. So I feel like that is big enough for it to be the thing. And everyone was doing it. Like, there were so many different variations of the Mannequin Challenge.
Interestingly enough,
there were so many different variations of animals attacking humans too. Like, that was viral.
Stop acting like Harambe spoke to these other animals and told them to start attacking us.
Listen, you're talking to a man who believes in unicorns. You can't tell me that animals don't talk to each other.
I'm sorry, guys, I'm back.
All right, so Dex, you're going with Harambe. Ty, you're going with Mannequin Challenge?
Yeah, I did go with Mannequin Challenge.
And Bill, you're going with Shirley?
Why would I be going with Shirley? Just because I'm going with Mannequin Challenge.
All right, Mannequin Challenge. All right, so the win, I mean, it was a very close vote. And because three of us voted for the Mannequin Challenge, that is actually the one that ended up winning it by one vote, because America voted mostly for the Shirley Caesar, you name it. But I
think those are newer. That's why people are voting for those. But like at the beginning of the year, they weren't even around, obviously.
Well, look, that has nothing to do with me. I'm just telling you what America voted.
Well, you know, I can protest America's vote because that's what we do, even though nothing happens if you protest the votes. But still, I'm just saying I'm doing it.
Well, this time looks like the protest actually counted for something. Because, we ended up turning that one back over, and the Mannequin Challenge is the viral moment of the year by one vote because three of us voted for it here on today's show. All right, before we get to the next award, we're going to play a little bit of not really a game, but Q&A is one of our favorite subjects on the show, one of our favorite categories, one of our favorite segments. And so we're going to do a little Q&A quickie here. To get, get us answering some stuff in the award show, kind of fill time out a little bit since we're doing it live this year and we don't have any crazy compilations to give you right now. By the way, stay tuned to our Facebook page because that is where we will be giving it all of our 2016 favorite moments and stuff like that. So make sure you stay tuned for that. But in the meantime, right now, we got some Q&A quickies, Ty. Let's read this first question. You ready?
Yeah.
Lego.
I'm sorry, I'm on the wrong screen. Would you rather always have to say everything on your mind or never be able to speak again? That was interesting. Give it a whirl, guys.
I'll go first. I'll say never be able to speak again because I feel like, one, I can communicate non-verbally, clearly. And two, I feel like, you know, with certain situations, people should know. Like, babies don't speak, and people know when babies are upset. People know when babies are hungry. People know when babies need their diaper changed. So I feel like I should be able to be the same way. I shouldn't have to speak to you for you to know that there's an issue or something wrong with me.
That was good. William?
That's a really good question. I don't think I could be silent for the rest of my life, though. Like, not being able to speak, I feel like that would frustrate me after a little bit of time. I mean, I could be able to communicate, I guess, write and other things, but being able to speak is so natural. Like, I don't know, just, you know, opening your mouth and words coming out. I feel like that's something that I wouldn't be able to get over. So I think I would go with always have to say everything that's on my mind. Bill?
This is interesting because some of the things that are on my mind are not supposed to be said. Like, they're not for anyone else but me, and they're probably not even for me. Asked me this 5 years ago, and my answer definitely would have been say everything that's on my mind because I did not care.
Now, do you think you can be quiet for the rest of your life?
No, I know I couldn't be quiet for the rest of my life, but I mean,
you have no choice.
You don't think it would drive you insane? Like, that's crazy.
But the thought of somebody knowing every single thing that's on my mind all the time, that also drives me crazy. yikes, that really is a good one. I'm gonna go with always say what's on my mind because I just can't be quiet the rest of my life. That's ridiculous.
Ty, to be honest with you,
there are people with traumatic brain injuries and they literally have to say what's on their mind because they don't, like, their filter is broken. So I feel like I could be one of those people. I can live with that. I'll just tell people I have a disability, and everyone will accommodate everything that I
was about to say the same thing. You get a lot of excuses. You probably get a handicap pass and everything. You could park in the nice spots.
And I would have, like, people make excuses for me, like Nicole and Jason. I'd be like, they would apologize for my behavior, and we would move on. And people would get used to me saying anything instead of me saying nothing, which they'd still accommodate me, but it wouldn't be as fun.
All right. Let's go back to the awards, back at the Bro Talk Awards 2016. The next category we have up is Meme of the Year. We still have Stunt Queen of the Year, Stunt of the Year, Clapback of the Year. And we're also going to, don't forget, be naming the funniest Black TV roles of all time. We will be ranking those coming up soon, so stay tuned for that. But right now we have the nominees for Meme of the Year. The nominees are The Arthur Hand. Huge.
That was a good one.
One Gotta Go, also huge. We've been playing that a lot on the show. Good Kermit, Bad Kermit. We have Mr. Krabs Vortex, which took over the early part of 2016. And the later part of 2016, What Does It Look Like I Do for a Living?
That blessed me.
That blessed you right
there. That blessed my soul.
So those are your nominees. Guys, what do you think you're going to go with? I can start it off if you want to. I'm going to go with One Gotta Go because I feel like that's the one that's going to stick around the most. But what do you guys have this year? Last year it was the lady from Beyond Scared Straight would meet you at the dope.
Who's going to win? Meet you at the dope.
I would go with One Gotta Go as well. I'm like low key obsessed with that one, and it really makes you think a lot. And it's fun. I think it's probably the most engaging one, and it's less like insulting, I think, than some of the other ones are. It's like really positive and fun, unless you start putting singers and stuff like that up there, then people get a little negative. But overall, like, I think it's the most positive one, and I like it the most. So I would go with that one.
Ty?
I don't know. I do like the One Gotta Go, but I think I'm going to go up the Good and Bad Kermit because I feel like that one has gone like really far.
It's really hilarious.
And those have gotten pretty funny. And they've also been serious, which is not as fun, but I think that's definitely the one.
I'm not sure where Kermit actually or who this person is that is supporting this late surge in Kermit's career, but they are doing a phenomenal job because last year, you know, they had the Kermit sipping tea one.
Right.
This year is Good Kermit, Bad Kermit. So it's just like
they also had Kermit, the Kermit where like he saw like him like backing off on the couch or something like that.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, wrote to the friend's house.
Yeah, this Kermit rushed his late career.
Kermit's going pretty good.
Right. Bill, which one are you going with?
That's me. I'm gonna go with Good Kermit and Bad Kermit. I saw like a few of them that actually made me laugh. Like the What Did I Do for a Living was like a cute little stunt. A little filler stunt for the week.
Filler stunt? That's what you're going to call it?
Yeah, I'm going to call that a filler. Like, as we went from Mr. Krabs' vortex to Arthur or whatever. It was
to Will's point, the What Do I Do for a Living came right after the election, too. So I feel like people slid that in there so we can laugh at something for a little bit. But I knew it was only around for a short period of time because we were still, like, fake serious and still got like, concerned about, like, the election and stuff like that. So I think that's why that didn't do as well.
All right. So we got two votes for the Good Kermit, Bad Kermit, two votes for One Gotta Go. America decided to vote. And guys, Dex, I'm sorry, they didn't agree with us at all.
Did they ever agree with me at all?
Arthur came in second. But the overwhelming winner of Meme of the Year this year was Good Kermit and Bad Kermit.
Let's go.
See?
Won it by a landslide.
Will not hit to what the young people are liking these days.
Shout out to the meeting of the year. Good Kermit, Bad Kermit. Time for Q&A quickie number two. Ty, back at it again.
Oh, this is cool. I like this.
With the questions. This is the last one, though.
Oh, well. No, I'm kidding. Wonderful. What's the worst holiday experience you've ever had?
That's a really good question.
That is really
good. I really, like, can't.
And it could be any holiday. It doesn't have to be Christmas, I don't think. Any holiday experience. It could be Memorial Day, Valentine's Day, whatever.
I guess I have a story while everyone else kind of thinks. Probably the worst holiday experience. I don't know if they mean, like, any holiday. But, like, I had this really weird Halloween one time where I was, like, at this new church, and they were, like, celebrating Halloween. And they were, like, trying to dress us up and, like, ghouls and devils. And it was, like, really strange. And they were, like, planning this big Halloween party, but they didn't even call it a harvest party like some churches do. Like, it was dead serious, like, Halloween party. And they were like, oh, yeah, come back. And I really felt like they did all these plans, and they asked us to come back. And I didn't go back because I really felt like it would be one of those things where they really suck the souls out of your body. So it was really strange. And the church was, like, right behind, like, this burial ground. And I really felt like dead ass, like if I went back, I would be sacrificed. So that was probably, I don't know if that was like a bad experience, but it was definitely very strange.
Tom, what kind of witchcraft and wizardry?
Yeah, like, I never told that story before, but it was like so weird. Like, I'm like, I really feel like if I go back to this church, like I'll be sacrificed. And I wasn't big enough to fight yet. So definitely wouldn't have happened. I would have been like young Simba being devoured by hyenas.
I would say mine. I'm gonna go now. I'm gonna say mine was probably right here on the show. Actually, the worst holiday experience was like my birthday when you know I was doing the show live here, talking to you guys, having a great time,
to let you know something. Your birthday is not a holiday.
That's debatable. And my sister put like a pie basically in my face. Like that was probably the worst holiday experience I've ever had.
Remember that story? Remember that question on Q&A about the about the mother who had diarrhea after
that grandma. When he spiked that lemonade.
So yeah, that was one of mine. So I just want to let you guys know that yeah, that was my holiday experience.
That was you?
Yeah, that was one of my holiday experiences. Yes.
No, it wasn't.
You got
absolutely. If you guys don't know the story, it happened on Memorial Day. Someone had put something in the punch, and I think it was like lactate or something like that, because you know it's flavorless. And then you know when you go back, it was all hell broke loose, and that was the story. So yeah, that is my
reason. Your family?
Yeah.
Absolutely. Why would you reveal that now? Like no. That story was so crazy that I don't believe you. Like no, really, that was really your family?
I don't either.
This is
so you wrote that. That was you that wrote that question?
Yeah, that was me that wrote that question. That one was me.
I need to see a receipt. Like, I need
you want to see a receipt? You want pictures of the evidence? Like, what do you want? What do you want from me?
Like, why would you not cakes full of poop? But why would you not tell us that until now? Like,
chocolate pudding everywhere. That's what you want. All right,
Is this the side of your family that I know or side of your family I don't know?
It's the side of family you know.
Oh my
God. Are you kidding me?
Keep it pushing. Bill?
No.
You can't just slide that in and expect us to not ask questions. Like, I don't even know.
Yeah, inquiry minds want to know.
What do we want to know? What do we want to know? We survived it. It was a terrible ordeal. It was a terrible ordeal. Toilets were blown, and, you know, we moved on. We recovered.
Who was we? Like, who did
it? I need to know who this uncle is, because I already know of one uncle, and that can't be him.
It wasn't an uncle. It was a cousin. It was a cousin. I kind of changed some of the names around for confidentiality purposes, but.
Oh, you changed some of the details like they did.
If you guys don't know what we're talking about, check out last year's Bro Talk Live Q&A part of the award show. And yeah, just listen. It was pretty gruesome. Was that last year or 2 years ago?
I think it was last year.
Right. Bill, you got one?
All of my holidays have been wonderful.
No, not the holiday.
You must keep things more high, Carrie.
I'll tell her one. One time he tried to cook these pies and they were awful.
Bill, what kind of pie you trying to cook?
Listen, so
would you try to put raisins in like the
No.
We had raisins and pecans in the sweet potato pie.
And pecans.
And pecans. And it was all lumpy and it was like the
So look. One Thanksgiving, right? So after my grandma passed away, I was delegated to make the sweet potato pies because I was the only person that knew the recipe. So like I'm making them, but the little blender thing, you know, we use one of the little handheld blender things.
Uh-huh.
But the blender's not working.
It just conked out.
Like it was cutting on and off. So it wasn't nothing I can do. Like
it's like a short and a quarter or something like that.
You know it's a short and a quarter, and it's still down there with a short in it.
Why you keep it? It's still got
things.
Why do you still have it?
Why do you still have the inventory? And so I'm like trying to make these pies and like I can't get the whole sweet potato like smooth out because it, like every time I turn it on, like it's like zoom, zoom. So after a while I was just like, you know what? You might have to chew this pie.
Wait, really quickly though, since you just talked about pies, that reminds me of one that I had like fairly recently, maybe like a year or two ago. I bake and I do really well with it, but I had never baked a pie before, and I baked an apple pie and I was like, oh, this is going to be the best thing ever. And I kept bragging about it. So then it came down time to like cut it or whatever. And I cut the pie and like these little like fruit flies or whatever start to come out of it.
Fruit flies.
Mortifying. Yes, it was like fruit flies. They were coming because apparently, if you cut apples and stuff, and you know how you sit them or whatever, you have to put them in the oven right away. Like you can't let them sit out for any amount.
Like you let them sit.
Well, I didn't. It was my first time.
You let them sit out with no wrap, like no Saran wrap or nothing.
How long? I put like a paper towel over the top of it so nothing falls into it. But apparently, fruit flies. I don't know where the hell they come from, but they were in my pie and coming out, like, and it was mortifying.
They were still alive once you once you cut it.
Some of them, yeah, some were alive and some were dead, and it was out of the oven too. But it had set for a little bit too, so it was bad.
How long was the fruit sitting outside?
Still eat your food after that happened?
Yeah, people still eat my food. I cook really well. You see the pictures I post on Instagram? Yeah.
Don't people still go to TGI Fridays?
That's pictures after you wipe the flies away, though.
No, that pie was in the garbage quicker than a meal from TGI on Fridays.
I'm about to say.
Who didn't respond to our accusation?
Who did not respond to us, by the way?
Dex, why you call it TGI Fridays?
No, that's what they call it, TGI Fridays.
No, it's called TGI Fridays.
The F stand for Friday.
No, that's not true.
That is true.
Dexter, enough. You and your fly pie. We had enough of you.
All right. Funny stories. Back to the Bro Talk Awards. Next category up we have is one that the fans were not able to vote on. Sorry, guys. But we figured, no offense, but we figured that since we covered all these clapbacks, we would be the best deciders.
We would
the
handle
ones
it.
That get this
award. We figured we
yeah, could. We can handle this one. So these are the nominees.
This one to the professionals.
For clapback of the year. Clapback of the year nominees. And the first nominee this year is going to be none other than Kris Jenner. Do you guys remember when she sunned Kim Kardashian and them? They told her she shouldn't be paying for Rob's house, who was almost 30.
Wait, is that the one that changed into a woman?
That's not the one. That is not Bruce. Rob,
the son.
No, Kris.
The one that's married to, the one that was with Blac Chyna.
I'm talking about Kris.
No, Kris is the mom. The other mom, the real mom.
Oh, she turned into a man. Okay, got it.
No, Caitlyn turned. Bruce, that's Bruce.
Oh, okay. All right, I'm all together now.
So you made me mess up. Kim told Kris that she shouldn't be paying for Rob's new house because Rob is almost 30. And so Kris told Kim, all of y'all can F off and thinking something else to talk about. I've seen you guys through so much S that I have to F and put up with. Are you kidding me? So she looked at them just like that. She said, I'm married for 72 days. Really? That was normal? You guys can do anything you want and it's okay. And I'm supposed to accept it all. I'm going to do the same thing for him. So stop judging me. Kris Jenner. Skye Jackson is the second nominee. You remember when she said Azealia Banks
needs to... The reading you just did right now, that sounded so much more like Monique from Precious than Kris Jenner, but you did an amazing job. Like, I'm very proud of you.
Skye Jackson is the second one. She said Azealia Banks needs to simmer down a little bit. Azealia Banks, if you don't recall, replied with, LOL says the Disney Channel reject. You know they don't like girls your color. Enjoy it while it lasts. Skye replied with, I had a career before Disney, and I'm sure I will after. And I know I won't turn out like you, bitter and miserable. Fix your life. Donald Trump is the third nominee for clapback of the year. Hillary said, it's awfully good that someone with the temperament of Donald Trump is not in charge of the laws of our country. Trump replied with, because you'd be in jail. Brandy, the fourth nominee. They asked Brandy, could she do the Monica challenge? She said, child bye. And she also decided to post this picture, child bye, on her Instagram page with the caption, oh my God, this statement has me so relevant and so famous again. Should I do the child bye challenge for more validation? LMAO. Or maybe I should drop a single like a remix or something so I can stay on top. Kim Kardashian West is next on the list. Kanye said, I did not diss Taylor Swift and I never dissed her, talking about the famous thing. She said she was having dinner with one of our friends whose name I will keep out of this, and she told him that I can't be mad at Kanye because he made me famous. Of course, we all know Taylor Swift then went to the Grammys and said, there are going to be people along the way who will try to undercut your success or take credit for your accomplishments or your fame. Kim didn't like that, so she decided to press send on this video that she had of Kanye and Taylor talking, and then leaked that to the internet, and all the blogs picked it up, saying that she exposed Taylor Swift for lying about famous. So guys, those are your nominees for Clapback of the Year. Who do you think should win this award? Is it Kris Jenner, Skye Jackson, Brandy, Donald Trump, or Kim Kardashian West?
I'm going to have to go with President-elect Donald Trump, unfortunately.
That was the moment of the election.
I remember watching
him laugh and screaming when he said that.
Yeah, I screamed. That was funny to me. That was at a point in time where I didn't really think he'd win. So I didn't laugh at stuff like that. So,
well, I did.
Oh, Dex.
I mean, no, I kind of did think he might have. I always said he had a huge possibility of winning, but at that time he was losing and everything so badly. I was like, oh, maybe I'm wrong. But so anyway, that moment was hilarious to me. And would still be. It still is. It doesn't matter if he's ridiculous.
That's another one that blessed me so good when he said that to her. Like, it was just like, why would you, like, that was hilarious. But I'm going to have to go with the Kim Kardashian West clapback. As much as I hate, not even hate, but I just, like, severely dislike Kim Kardashian because of who, like, what she is. But that is probably, like, the, like, the only other thing she could do was be tiny at this point.
She got Taylor Swift good and together, didn't she?
Except the fact that, like, she sold drugs instead of it being T.I. Like, that's the like, clapback of the year for me.
I'm going to agree with Will because, remember, I mean, the other ones were good, and the close second to me would be Kris Jenner's clapback against her girls. Like, she did a really good job with that one, but she started crying. So I feel like if you start crying, like, you lose. Even though if you get it, you get somebody real good and you cry, you lost. I feel like it's got to be Kim Kardashian here because remember, after she put this stuff out there, first of all, she broke the internet again when she did that. And we all started celebrating in the Kim or Kanye or Kim ended Taylor party, like, or Taylor Swift is over party. Like, Kim is the queen for that one. Clapback queen.
That was a huge, and you know, I was very happy because, you know, my feelings towards young Taylor Swift, but I think I got to go with Donald. So I think we're going to have a tie, Doc. We're really going to have a tie, like, between Donald Trump and Kim Kardashian West, because me and Ty voted for Donald, you and Bill voted for Kim, so I think it's just going to have to end up with
that. I feel like, though, we've let Donald win a bit much. He doesn't need to win anything else.
I'm with that, so we got to go with that, so yeah.
so you're changing your vote, Ty?
We can't let Donald Trump win anything else.
He won Stunt Queen of the Year last year.
And he wins a lot of Bro Talk Awards. We're done with that.
He's the all-time leader.
I'm with everybody else. He's like Meryl Streep of Bro Talk Awards. We're not doing it. We'll move him over.
All right. So I guess Clapback of the Year will go to none other.
It will go to Kim Kardashian.
Kardashian West.
Proudly so. Something against Donald Trump.
Thank you, Ty, for your awesome insight and your wisdom to change your vote at the last minute.
Come on, wisdom.
Just like Donald Trump.
Only other people followed suit.
Right? Exactly. Like the Electoral College, right? They had their last chance yesterday, and they didn't do. All right. Time to, you know, as award shows, they give out, you know, awards for, you know, the current time, and they also give out lifetime achievement awards.
Chris Brown got to be in this one.
MTV did the highest MCs in the game, and they ranked Kanye West. They ranked Kanye West as the number one MC in the game.
Oh, wow.
What does MC stand for?
Mic check, 1, 2, 1, 2. Oh, Master of Ceremonies. That's what it is.
I was going to say, try again.
So we're going to do the funniest black TV roles of all time. Because that's what we do here at Bro Talk Live. So guys, here is the chart. We have to go 1 through 10. We already narrowed it down to our 10 a couple of weeks ago. And now we're just gonna fill in where people fit from 1 to 10. We're gonna start you off with Dave Chappelle's role as Rick James. Where do you think that should rank just off the top of your head as the funniest black TV roles of all time?
I say 10.
10, yeah. I'm with that.
10? You guys don't think that was It wasn't
we
a
said
funny
10.
Role.
No, it was funny, but funny enough to be 10.
To be serious, I've never seen it, so 10.
Michael Kyle, where does Michael Kyle fit from My Wife?
Oh, we can't do it like this because
I would say number 2 for now.
Number 2 for now, okay. Yeah. Dex number 2.
I'm gonna go with number 2 for now.
I'm definitely putting him at least 5. I'm sure we have better than this.
So let's meet somewhere in the middle. Three. Can we agree at three times?
Three is fine for now. Yeah, three works.
Next up, Regine Hunter from Living Single.
Do we have a number 11?
Can we have two tens?
I would say maybe like nine.
No.
No, like, she's got to be 10.
She would be 10 and Chappelle should be 9.
That's a lot.
I definitely think Rick James, Chappelle's impersonation of Rick James was a little funnier than
Regine Hunter. Like, I wouldn't choose her to wipe my ass if I was crippled.
Oh my
God. No thank you.
Oh God.
Bernie Mac, Bernie McCullough on the Bernie Mac show. Where should he rank in the top 10 list?
It's I mean, honestly, within that show, I'd probably say 10.
No. What? He's at least 5 to 4.
He's definitely at least 4.
See, I said 10 because I probably watched that show for 10 minutes of my life, period. I just would never watch that show. It just wasn't that good.
We'll keep him at 5. Where is Carlton Banks rank in your top 10 list?
Maybe 3.
Of all
I'm
time.
Definitely putting Carlton at 2.
Are you kidding me?
Carlton is not 2. He's 3.
Above or below Michael Kyle?
Like, you're not going to give a sidekick a higher ranking than to my, like, Michael Kyle, who ran.
We'll give you a high ranking.
We're not doing that. Oh, I'm the one.
the one sidekick who actually takes his role.
Come on, Unicorn. Give him that Unicorn side.
All right, so we got Regine at 10, Rick James at 9, Bernie, Carlton.
How did Regine get on this? Like, what was happening?
Number 1. And you can lock that. Put a lock next to that.
Is there an L sign you can stick on that? Lock him in.
Lock that in.
There's no way anyone's beating Martin.
Martin is hilarious.
The person that you guys voted for last week that you chose to put
in. Solid 10. Absolutely not.
No, she's funny. I would say like 6.
No, she's definitely 9. Like, she's funnier than Regine. I'll give her 9.
She's funnier than Regine too. First off, Rick James was a skit. This is a person.
It was a skit, but it was legendary. You hear me?
Look at her name.
LaVita Alize Jenkins.
In
6. Front of Rachel, that's all I can.
I'll put her at 6, yeah.
No, then we'll give her a solid 7. I'm putting her at 9.
Because 2. Will Smith is number 2. He's number 2.
Prince is definitely number 2.
And you can lock that in, too.
You can lock that in. I'm with Dex with that one.
Better than Michael Kyle?
Yo, and I
personally don't think he was better than Michael Kyle, but we'll put him at number 2.
Yes, you do.
No, I don't.
Yeah, no, that looks proper to me. I would say
looks
Martin.
Good.
Yeah, that looks good to me so far.
And I have half a mind to move Michael Kyle below Carlton, to be honest with you, so we can move
you
on.
You are good and crazy.
All right, Marlon Wayans from The Wayne.
Can I put him at 4?
I would say 5. Number 5.
I would say 4, like Marlon.
4? 4?
He's really funny on this show.
That was
4.
A good show.
Y'all, they knew. Yeah.
4?
I love that show.
Like 4 or 5, yeah.
What slots do we have open? Put him in one of them. Put Rick James at 8 and put him at 9.
No, he's definitely at least 5.
That Rick James stuff is not even funny. Are you?
Rick James
is
hilarious. I'll quit my job. 6. I won't have Marlon at 9. No.
No, he's at 6.
You'll give Marlon at least a 6.
And last but not least,
you have him slightly over.
Big Beauty, LaFontaine Thorne.
He's like 7 or 8.
Wait, we gotta redo this.
Is number 1. Number one. Big Beauty is hilarious. She is the funniest character that has ever, ever been on the television screen. She is hilarious.
You guys don't know the show that Big Didi is from.
They sleep on that show so much. Me and Jason will have a half and half marathon in a minute. I need the key to unlock that number 1 to put Big Didi where she belongs.
I would say she's right under LaVita or right next to her.
I will stab you in the fucking neck. No way.
Listen, let's put Big Didi at number 5.
Number 1.
It's not number 5. Come on, guys.
1. Big Didi isn't funnier than Carlton?
No.
I'm just asking Jason.
No. Someone else right now.
No, she is funnier than Carlton.
Can we at least agree, Jason, that the right side of the screen is correct?
No.
Yeah, no. Marlon Wayans shouldn't be that low. He should be number 6. I think he's funnier than Bernie Mac. And also, I think Big Didi needs to be over there. She is not top 5.
No. Big Didi is hilarious.
Or Carlton Banks. Big Didi is way funnier than Carlton Banks, and you know it.
All right, hold on. So let's take a vote. Bill, you think Big Didi's funnier than Carlton?
Absolutely.
And she should be in that poll.
She should be at least number four.
All right, yeah, I agree as
but
well.
She's funnier than Michael Connell too. Funnier than Will Smith. The only person who's giving her a run for her money is Martin.
But Carlton Banks is like, he's crazy hilarious. Like, remember the dance that he would do? Like, that dance alone, like, moved him above her. Like, he wasn't like shady funny. He was genuinely funny. He was hilarious. Like, there's
Carlton
so many.
Is a legend. Carlton is a legend.
Like, I cannot believe we would put her before Carlton Banks. Like, that is insane to me.
The only reason why I would agree with Dax and put Carlton first is because Carlton is such a legend. And
Hold it, unfortunately, did not
get the recognition she deserved.
He's not a legend because of anything but that raggedy little half dance he did. I want you all to settle down.
Dance.
I want you all to settle
Wait
down.
Wait a minute.
Carlton made sweater vest cool. Like, this man is like,
no, Dex wants Carlton up at number four because Dex reminds himself of Carlton. That's
clearly.
The buffoon. Right,
I think we can leave it as it is. I think this is good.
Thank you.
Martin 1, Will Smith 2, Michael Kyle 3, Big DD 4, Carlton 5, Marlon Wayans 6, Bernie Mac 7, LaVita Alize Jenkins 8.
I cannot believe, out of all the wonderful characters in the world, that Ray Gene Hunter. Like, what was going on? Like, I felt like that week there was something wrong with my soul and my spirit. And that's what was wrong. I knew you guys were up to some foolishness. Ray Gene, no.
All right, time for the last two big awards of the night, and we'll get up out of here. Thanks for sticking with us, guys, during that little hottest MCs list or whatever you want to call it. Stunt of the year.
Mm.
This award.
Doesn't this historically go to Chris Brown?
Historically.
This year we have a bunch of different nominees. Chris Brown's not among them. Surprisingly,
no, he's been quiet.
He's had quite the quiet year, and every time we say that, immediately afterwards, something happens.
Suddenly, straightway.
So be on the lookout, guys, for Chris Brown acting up in the next couple of weeks. We are sure of it because it always happens that way. Your nominees for Stunt of the Year this year are Ryan Lochte.
I hate this guy. No.
Goodness.
I don't want him to win nothing.
His
ever.
Story about what happened.
When he lost, I was so delighted that I didn't know what to do with myself.
I was
number two, Blac Chyna and Rob Kardashian's romance. And, you know, the whole drama with Kylie and Tiger and Blac Chyna and Tyga and Kylie and Rob. It's just a little bit weird. Another Stunt of the Year nominee, Melania Trump, when she decided to steal Michelle Obama's whole speech at the Republican National Convention, and yet her husband still won. Stunt of the Year nominee number four were the clown attacks that happened across the U.S. And this is a map of several clown attacks that happened across this country. And last but not least, the 2016 election. Was that the Stunt of the Year? Guys, these are your nominees for the 2016 Stunt of the Year. Who do you guys think should win?
So I'll start. So initially, in the summertime when Hillary Clinton had this election won, Lochte and Rio was clearly the stunt of the year. And then November came and Donald Trump is the president. So that has to be like the election 26, because more people still voted for Hillary Clinton than they did Donald Trump. And he's
more people voted for Hillary Clinton than any other
anyone
losing president in American history. She's the only person she's behind is Obama in 2008 for the most votes ever in the nation's history. That is the only person she's behind, and yet she lost.
So by virtue of that, because I still don't really understand how she lost, by virtue of that, the election
Russia,
2016,
the Russians.
That's the Stunt of the Year. I still, like, how? If we, how?
She won, she beat him by over 2 million votes.
Over 2 million votes. Now
because
here's
my question. If the electors represent, if the Electoral College represents the popular vote, and the popular vote was Hillary Clinton, explain to me how he won.
Can't do it.
Stunt of the year.
But how did, but she lost, but 2 million though.
Can we get over it?
Like that's a lot.
Dex, who you going with? Stunt of the year.
In light of recent events, I have to go with Black China Rob. Did you know today it came out that she beat him up last week, jumped on the man and beat him down and had to be pulled off of him? The fact that this woman...
He got pulled off by Prince's boyfriend, right? Or something like that, right?
Uh-huh. And the fact that this woman at this time last year was like crying over... She's like crying because Kylie had took China. And at this point this year, this woman has a baby by Rob Kardashian, Lord, and like beating him up. And her text message revealed that she beat Tiger up. Like, Black China is not only the stunt queen of the year, but her, this whole Rob Kardashian thing that she did, deserves stunt of the year. Like, she's a legendary stunt queen at this point.
All right, so Ty, you're officially voting for the election or Melania Trump? I wasn't sure.
The election, there's no way that anyone's a bigger stunt queen in America.
All right, so I will tell you the top two votes in this category this year were the election 2016 and Black China and Rob. But according to these votes, including the ones that we just casted right now, election 2016, ended up being the stunt of the year.
As it should have.
Everyone for voting for that one.
We're like usually spot on with people, though. Like, that's like weird.
What did you say?
We're like spot on with the people. That's like
weird. No, when you say we, it doesn't include me because I can't pick anything right.
We as a cast. So our correctness overshadows your lack.
You guys are carrying my weight at this point.
All right, and the last award of the night, Stunt Queen of the Year. The biggest award last year won by Donald Trump. The year before that won by none other than Chris Brown. This year we have a crop of different nominees, including Donald Trump again. He is the first person. Actually, no, Chris Brown was nominated twice. I mean, he was nominated last year as well, but he didn't win. He is a two-time nominee now for this award, joining Chris Brown and Azalea Banks, who was not nominated this year. But these are your nominees for the 2016 Stunt Queen or King. Because, you know, we don't discriminate of the year.
Guess what, Beyonce? Little white girls want to be like you just as little black girls do. But instead of recognizing that, you would rather perpetuate the great battle of the races.
He's like, I'm not a crackhead. And I'm like, oh, I'm not too sure about that. And I guarantee you, this is going to be the year where he tries to become a stunt king.
I will diagnose Kanye if he comes and sits in this living room. I will do a full evaluation on Kanye West to let you know that Kanye West definitely has problems.
The way it works is I just could shoot somebody in the middle of Fifth Avenue and I wouldn't lose any votes, okay, folks? It's just that my people are loyal, okay? Crooked Hillary, okay, that's why I call
it. Tiger's gonna be his son's uncle, and it's just like, stuff like that. I just think he's always dragging different men into this situation, and now you've taken it too far with trying to marry Rob Kardashian.
Those are your nominees for Stunt Queen of the Year. Who you guys think deserves this award? Dex, why are you making that face?
This is so difficult because, like Donald Trump literally said, I could go out on Fifth Avenue and shoot somebody and not lose any votes. He was dead serious, and he was right.
And he was right.
Then you have Tommy Lauren, who just says any damn thing that she wants to say negative about African Americans. Then you have Orlando Brown, who eats people's butts on TV and camera.
And leaves the
Kanye West, who's a lunatic, period. Then you have Black China, who planned and plotted to be a single mother. Who does that?
This by far, by the way, this was the close, literally one vote separated first through second, and then two votes separated third through fourth. Like,
it's
literally.
So difficult.
It's really close.
I am going to go with Tommy Lauren, though, because, like, although a lot of these other people, Donald Trump included, they're all crazy and they're doing like weird things and they affect other people. For some reason with me, Tommy Lauren bothers me the most because people accept it. And I think if she, like, not only people like that are like white accept it, but black people like Charlamagne like accept it and like continue to like push her narrative, and people don't reject it like they do with Donald Trump. Like, when Donald Trump says something, like, Charlamagne and Trevor Noah, they will reject what he's saying. Like, they will be like, this is BS, like, this is ridiculous. They don't give him like a platform to come and talk to them and stuff like that.
Well, Donald Trump already has the platforms, like,
but I'm just saying, like, but they're giving
Trevor Noah doesn't accept Tommy Lauren either.
Who doesn't?
Yeah, I think that was a little overdone. I don't feel like don't feel like he gave her a platform. Tommy Lauren has, before she went on The Daily Show, had over 490 followers on Facebook and Twitter. And people watched that stupid Facebook Live show that she had called The Blaze and stuff like that before she even got on Trevor Noah's show.
I mean, I disagree. And I feel like I'm going to give her my vote for Stunt Queen of the Year.
Okay.
And she can take him, Trevor Noah, Charlamagne can join her within that vote too.
I don't want Tommy Lauren to win anything. But she can jump off a bridge or drink bleach. Like, that's what she can do at this point.
Drink bleach.
See, like that? We got to keep it in the Brown family, I feel like. Like, I'm going to vote for either Orlando Brown or Donald Trump.
In the Brown family.
Because Orlando Brown has just, he's been like the male version of Tommy Lauren. He's just been saying anything. And I think the difference is Tommy Lauren is doing that because she needs to be able to keep her check. Orlando Brown actually believes what he says. Or Donald Trump, because Donald Trump has been legitimately just kind of like feeling out this entire presidency thing. He's just and maybe if I throw paint on the wall, maybe it'll stick. So let's see what I can do over here. Like, he's legit just pulling a rabbit out of the hat,
This is a super close vote. I need one vote from you.
God,
you've been giving Donald Trump the character blues all year. I mean, it's up to you, dog, but we need one vote. Literally, one vote separates first through second, so I need a vote.
Okay. I have to vote. Okay, I can't go with the black. I'm going to go with Donald Trump.
All right, Donald Trump. Ty, who are you going with? Black China? Who here are your nominees? Black China, Tommy Lauren, Orlando Brown, Kanye West, or Donald Trump?
I was thinking about Black China because she stunted a whole family out of this thing.
In a way.
It was masterfully.
And it was just like crazy. But Donald Trump stunted a whole presidency. So
an entire country.
Like, he stunted a whole country. And like, he's now going on, what kind of tour is it? A thank you tour? Where he is telling people, yeah, I tried that out, and I thought it was stupid at first. But I was like, and people are really believing this stuff. And so I went with it. Like, he's telling people this. And they're, like, in the audience looking so confused. Because they were like, yeah, put Hillary in jail. He's like, ah, come on, guys. You know I didn't mean any of that.
Like, I think that, like, redeems him. Like, I feel like he loses. Because if he was serious about some of the stuff that he was saying, I feel like that would make him, like, he should be in jail, and that makes him like a stunt king. But the fact that he
that's what a stunt is. Like,
that's what a stunt is.
That is, we are good friends. He's like, oh, I wouldn't put. She's a grandmother. She's my friend. I wouldn't. She's at a Christmas party. I wouldn't put her in jail.
That was a stunt. That's what a stunt is.
Literally of a stunt.
Like, Donald Trump is the definition of stunt. Like, that is what he does.
I don't know. I guess the reason why I wouldn't pick Donald Trump, because I'm. Please don't hate me, but I'm like low-key entertained by him still. I think stuff like that is funny. Like, I like that kind of stuff.
My vote is going for China, and if my vote goes for China, then that ties the whole thing up. Donald Trump and China are actually tied.
Oh, my God. Really?
Dex, if you had to vote between Black China and what she did versus Donald Trump and what he pulled off, both are impressive feats.
Yeah, keeping in mind
what it shook up in Atlanta, now she's in the Hollywood Hills for life. But she got Kardashian checks coming in for the rest of her life. Donald Trump won the election.
The both of them are stunt king. The both of them.
This is so good. I
can't delete the other ones because they don't matter. It came down to Black China and Donald Trump.
I would probably go with Black China because at the end of the day, Donald Trump he's Donald Trump. You know what I mean? Like, this man, like, whatever. But Black China really swindled herself into being a single mother. Like, who does that? Like, for some reason, that to me is like, she stunted with her whole life and body to just get revenge on Kylie Jenner, an 18-year-old.
And literally, the moment she realized that she had that baby, she was done with Rob. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, it was this whole act. Like, as if they were actually a real couple, they had this whole reality show going on. As soon as she dropped that baby, she started beating on Rob, and now they're broken up and all this other stuff. And she can't lose. Like, Donald Trump can still be impeached. You know what I'm saying? Like, this could still happen. Like, Donald Trump can actually still lose.
And think about it. Think about it. Rob has five sisters. I saw a meme like this the other day. Rob has five sisters, and none of those sisters can beat up Black China.
Wait a minute. There's only one that has a chance, and that's OJ's daughter.
Okay. So are we going with, I guess, Black China? Dex, you say Black China?
I'm getting messages that say that I shouldn't.
Are you going to make Donald Trump the first two-time winner of Stunt Queen of the Year, or are you going to make Black China the first female winner of Stunt Queen?
People are saying that she didn't swindle her way in there, Rob, and she needed to get out of Rob's situation because he was depressed. Rob was big, fat, and depressed before she met him, when she met him, and after she left him. So Black China is Stunt Queen.
Dex, Dex, before you make your decision, listen. One stunted a family. The other one stunted a nation.
But the thing is,
a country.
I feel like with Donald Trump, though, like, his stunts is more dependent on other people.
But listen, you
know,
dependent on a family. The last person that stunted an entire country was Christopher Columbus. Like, it was 1492.
But we don't acknowledge Columbus, though. We like, forget about him.
Christopher we acknowledge is Wallace, okay?
That's my point. The last person that was able to stunt an entire country died of chlamydia and gonorrhea.
Well, chlamydia and gonorrhea is coming for Donald Trump, then.
I don't think we're that lucky.
With all respect to the presidency.
So, Dex.
And if we're talking about chlamydia and gonorrhea, and we're talking about Donald Trump and Black China, I mean...
Black.
She might be winning a lot more than Stunt Queen of the Year.
So next, you going with China or Trump?
I'm going with China.
All right, it's official. Black China is the 2016 Stunt Queen of the Year. I can't believe I would have never guessed at the beginning of the year that we would have given this award to Black China. Like, I didn't think she had enough personality. I didn't think she had enough relevance. But somehow, some way,
she doesn't pull it up. She got here. Because of her box.
Oh my gosh. All right. Well, thanks, everyone. This has been the Bro Talk Awards 2016.
Wow.
Donald Trump, we have avoided naming him the two-time winner of Stunt Queen of the Year, but we have crowned Black China the new bearer of this award. Thanks, guys, for voting and tuning in. I really appreciate it. This is the most votes we've ever gotten for the Bro Talk Awards, so we thank everyone for voting on BroTalkLive.com. Make sure you check out our Facebook page for the best of videos that are coming between, you know, now and the new year. We appreciate all your shares and your likes and everything. Thanks for joining us all season long, by the way. This has been one of the best years that we've ever had with the show, so we really, really, really appreciate it. Don't forget to subscribe to our new channel, youtube.com/BroTalkLive, or just search BroTalkLive on YouTube and subscribe to our new channel. We still have all the old videos on our old channel, but we appreciate you following the new one. We will be on break for a couple of weeks now until late January, but we will be getting back to you, and we will have new shows for you coming up in 2017. Do you guys have any shout-outs, any seats, anything else to talk about for the remainder of 2016?
We definitely got lots of shout-outs.
A quick shout-out to – huge shout-out to everyone who's supporting the cause. Also, a shout out to Rich, Dion, and Vanasia. A shout out to Fatima. A shout out to Shakima. A shout out to Reese. And a shout out to Ashley Joy. Everyone who's watching the show and tweeting me, and Tanea tweeting me about the show, and all members of Team Dex. Like, you guys are an amazing group of people, and everyone who watches the show and talks to me about Bro Talk Live and are on Facebook right now talking about Bro Talk Live. Like, thank you so much for the support. Like, I really appreciate it. We really appreciate it. And we wouldn't be doing the show if you guys weren't watching.
We definitely wouldn't, because this is so much work. And the only reason that I'm doing it is because actually people tune in and watch. So, Ty, do you have any shout outs?
I would like to shout out my assistant, my fiance, Nicole, who...
you better get a start.
Who does watch the show. She always sees me, and she makes faces at me if I curse too loud or say something too crazy. And she helped me when I was choking on popcorn and had a wardrobe malfunction all at the same time. Earlier in the show, she threw me a new shirt. You guys probably didn't notice.
Oh, I noticed and tweeted about it.
Oh, did you? But yeah, and shout out to everybody who just supports us and watches the show. We really appreciate it because it is fun, and we want to keep doing it.
Bill?
Yes, I would like to thank everybody that supported us. Mother dearest, my sisters, my brothers, my coworkers who surprised me. Like, I walked into work one day and they were like, oh my goodness, it was just so funny, I couldn't stop watching. Like, I really appreciate you guys. Steph, Diana, Maureen, Colette, my students. Like, my students are like, they have a group chat and they included me in this kid group chat and they like text about it. They're like live texting and it's amazing to me. Jordan, Sammy, Alex, my whole track team, like, oh my gosh, it's amazing to me that it's catching on like this. Like, that's crazy to me. And to the woman that saw me and Ty when we were in Walmart that time. She watches the show. I don't know. I didn't catch her name.
It was so random woman that watches the show. And I mean, I'm not calling you a random, but it was just like really weird. Like, we're not used to that. Like, we're not used to people walking up to us and say, hey, we watch your show. It's just really weird.
I wasn't, because when she said, I thought she said to Ty, I thought she was like, nice sweater. She was like, I like your show. And I was like, wait, what? She was like, yeah, I watch Bro Talk Live. And I was like, oh. So I really appreciate it. Like, it's amazing. Tanea for like tweeting. Eugene, my homie that I work with at the airport, he's always watching. Rick Lee, SK, Mike, EJ, Jordan, Jennifer, Kim, everybody. Thank you guys. But this was such an amazing year.
And then wait, really quickly before we go, a couple more. Ludi, Julian, Vance, and Poochman.
And John.
John.
I want to give a shout out to my wife. She always makes, because we're on the West Coast here, so we always do the show actually during dinner time. And she tries to actually make dinner in a way that doesn't interrupt the show. And we live in an apartment, so it's not like a huge amount of room. So I just want to thank her for being so kind and gracious all the time. And let her know that I appreciate it.
Sammy, Alex, Johnny, Moyo, Isaiah, Sonya. Okay, I think I'm done.
All right.
Haley, cool. Y'all know Haley. Haley,
any why? Announcements over the winter break that we got to get out?
Yes. On New Year's Eve, I will be preaching for a New Year's Eve service, for a watch night service at New Life Christian Fellowship.
The gospel of Jesus Christ, correct? The
good gospel. You better believe it. Ain't no other gospel. So you all can join me. Service begins at 9 o'clock.
That's my church.
I guess I should. Yes, that's Ty's church. I will be preaching there live and in living.
I will be leading praise and worship.
Come through.
I actually might not. I might not be there. But
Dex, do you have any meet and greets that you got going on?
I have no meet and greets. But I just want you guys to know that the power is within you. Find it, live it, and like I guarantee you, your 2017 will be as amazing as my 2016 was.
How many unicorn like little shirts do you got?
I mean, the collection is growing.
All right. Well, for Dex, for Ty, for Bill, my name is Jason. Make sure you guys have a happy holidays, whatever you celebrate during this season. I want you to have a happy holiday season, happy New Year, Merry Christmas, happy Hanukkah, happy Kwanzaa, all of the above.
Happy birthday to William.
Happy birthday to Ty and I.
Exactly. Happy birthday to all you December babies. We definitely are grateful to have you on the show. So yeah, everyone be safe. Join us back here in late January, and we will have a new edition of Bro Talk Live each and every week starting then. For Ty, for Dex, for Bill, this has been another edition of Bro Talk Live, another season, and we are out.